So in the particular environment, we have to deal with many tasks. So how you will address it with those many tasks? Okay. So for which we depend on different synchronization techniques. Running to wedding state. Running directly to the situation, processes and activation that the CPT is replied by the class. Now, if some problem occurs, so there is no other alternative, it directly moves to where? To the wet system. So in that case, there is no interruption. There is no interruption. Next one is when the process ends, starts and finishes its operation, it comes to exit. So in those cases, those are non-primitive. Non-primitive means at any circumstances, we cannot stop. At any circumstances, we cannot stop. So you must finish it. You must finish it. The remaining are some primitive. Remaining part are the primitive are not with any case, any chance, the other task may, our other task may affect the running process. Other task may affect the running process. So what we are trying to achieve from it means suppose some urgent process comes, some system related process comes. So because it is related to the system process, we have to execute such process at the beginning. We have to give the first try. So we have to entertain such process at all. So what about the ongoing process? Already some process is needed explained by the system. How strong? Okay. How we can create an interruption here? So that the ongoing process stops for a finite amount of time. Maybe decide in the area back to the operating queue. Or maybe if some failure occurs, then only we can send that process to where? To the waiting state. Otherwise, then it will move to where? To the ready queue. Okay. So these are the cases by which we can create some kind of obstacle and we can stop the process and we can entertain a new coming process. So we'll see different mechanisms and rest of which different algorithms are divided. Okay. Now, all the other scheduling algorithms are well, the primitive, the last one is here, and consider the access to the shared data that may give one operation where we have to depend on. The primitive action point in the kernel mode, because kernel is the boss of the occurring during the essential of the voice activity. Maybe some voice related activities are performed inside the kernel, so which is not shown to the user because those are background processes. So such cases, maybe we need the some kind of primitive background. Okay? So next is the syncing algorithm optimization guide already we have gone in the previous slide. So what are those? The maximum CPU utilization, that is our main achievement we try to achieve from it. One is maximum CPU utilization we try to achieve. Second one, Maximum throughput. Next, the minimum turnaround time. Next, the minimum waiting time. The next, the minimum response time. So these are the things we try to achieve from the scheduling algorithm what we have just started at the previous level. So, next is the scheduling criteria, the formulas for each. Okay, so already we have known about it. So what does utilization mean? Is the CPU busy? It's always in which load every select access. Second one, throughput means? Yes. Next, the turnaround time. Turnaround time means when the particular process starts its execution and when it gets entry and when it exits. The duration, the gap, is called your turnaround time. Next, the waiting time. Waiting time means how much time or the duration a particular process waiting inside the ready. You have the ready before the execution, the process must reside in the ready. So how much time that particular process wasting in the ready? That is the term we use, the technical term we will use, that is the waiting time. Okay, so formula, what is the formula for it? That not in the waiting time? For starting time means when you are preparing the gas, when a particular process starts, at what time it starts, and when it arrives into the ready. The whole duration, it may decide in the ready. That is called your waiting time. Next, the response time. Response time means when it gets the first interaction, first chance to the CPU. Before the execution, it may reset somewhere. Now, when there is a chance for the execution, at what moment it starts its execution means it is directly interacting with the CPU. From that time, that is called your first response. Time minus arrival time of the So these are the different components. Last, we calculate. Relative delay means for each process, maybe for context switching, due to the context switching, it jumps from one to another, then changes mode. In such operation, it may take some time. Okay, maybe waiting in the ready queue, maybe from in the first term. What is that? Then it's called your first term process. So how it works? How it works?
And the first term is comes to the
So what is the amount of potential? a particular algorithm for this system or this architecture, this memory is the group. So now this is the outcome. We can call the learning outcome of feedback. Okay? Our main intention is what? What is the outcome we want? Find the suitable algorithm and allocate a suitable algorithm for a particular system. To achieve what? To achieve what? Maximum profit and maximum CPU utilization. Okay, at minimum waiting time, minimum turnaround time, minimum response. Those are the things we try to achieve. So those are all the outcomes. Okay. So this is one problem. Next, this is the another case. The first case is saying that, but suppose that process arrives in different timing. Now the order of PP is need to wait for 27 milliseconds before the execution. When the second case, it shows the P3 starts at 3. Starts at 3. Why? I have said about the order is P3, P1, P2. But here we have the slight expansion. P2, P3 and P1. So in that way, the order is changed. Okay? So this is already covered. So now in the shortest job first, already you have just started about the shortest job first. So what you have started in the shortest job first? Which based on the priority. Based on the priority. Again, one thing. When we are allocating the CPU to a particular process, allocating the CPU to a particular process is in the execution. Suppose that process having the list, what? List burst time, quick. How about the burst time? List priority value. In SF, what is the first? When a process having the least priority value, maybe burst time is high, no problem. Don't worry about it. Okay? But priority value must be big. Priority value must be big. How you say it is big? Least value, least integer value. Having the highest priority. Always keep in mind. Least priority value. Higher priority. Okay? So in that order we have to add. Suppose in that case, suppose another process if comes after 5 processes, suppose another process comes, 6 number process comes. Again with the highest priority. Again with the highest priority. Where will we keep? Generally we are keeping all processes in the ready queue. Now where will we keep? The top or bottom? See, zero go. We have 5 different processes, P1, P2, P3, P4, and C5.
Okay.
experience of some moves of the plan and the other. So what did you do? Shortest remaining time first. Shortest remaining time first. Where two things will happen. Two cases will appear. One is what? Maybe all process arrive at constant time. All process may arrive at common timing. Maybe some cases are there.
Remaining first
will Okay? Now, the next case is what? Suppose this is already another relative step. Now, remaining first time is less. Now, the new arrival process first time is high. So, which one is less? This one is only process less. With less time it needs to form the combination. So, it will continue. It will not suspend it. It will continue till the end. Right? During the end, during the end phase, if no other process approach, no other process, no, there is no other arrival, process arrival, whatever, it will continue and no comparison. If it is finished, then the new process again will compare with the available process first step, then allocate the list, the process is coming the list first step. How to solve it, okay? I'm just giving you the hints, okay? How to solve it, right? When it is your duty to solve and solve it, okay? So you can take it as an assignment. You can take this as an assignment and show it to me. So this is, this new technique called your, the extension part of your essay, extension part of your essay, that is the rename of SRPF. Now, what is the remaining first time of P1? one level efficiency and one level effectiveness. So this three will come.